Good morning and welcome to the video. We are 11 days out from the Austin Marathon and today I did 5 miles. So we're over the peak, we're over the hump of the high mileage for the entire marathon prep, and now we're just slowly decreasing mileage moving into next Sunday, which is the marathon. All right, so swinging by, check on the new warehouse. We are supposed to move in February 1st, and as you can see, that hasn't happened yet. So the only thing we're working on is the roads to be paved, like the parking lots to be paved, and they're in the process right now. So tentatively, we're supposed to move into the new warehouse February 18th. So we'll see. All right, so tell us a story about what happened on the skateboard this week.
I don't think it worked for a little while, so I had a couple weeks off. I'm real confident with it usually. Like, I fly on it probably full speed, 30 miles per hour. Went to get the mail, got the mail, had the mail going back, and out of nowhere, the trucks just did a 90 degree angle. And usually if you're going and you hit a bump and you can feel yourself going off at top speed, you can usually like, you get off it and start running as fast as you can, and like, and it was just going so fast and so sudden that I just wiped down completely. It was one of those things where you wipe out and then you like catch yourself. I was just like, I'm all intact, no broken bones.
Let me see the scar.
And there's, actually, I don't think there's any scar there anymore.
Disappeared already?
It's more on my butt. I'm not gonna show my butt.
So we've already started planning what kind of vibe we want at this new warehouse. And as soon as you enter the new warehouse, we're gonna have this steer hanging up front with a Bear Performance sign. But I figured I'd hang it up because it's just beautiful. Why not put it up already? Found this at a local shop on South Congress, downtown Austin. How perfect is this for our new place? So we're all super excited for the warehouse move just because, one, it's more space. It allows us to do a lot more with inventory in the gym portion of it. And it's just super nice. Like, it's super updated. It's still under construction. But like, all the lighting is LED, the ceilings are higher, there is updated like cabinets and office space. It's beautiful. And if you know how I feel about warehouse space, I got a soft spot in my heart for it. So it kind of just like super jacks me up. So the plans are, we're hiring some companies to help us move the gym equipment. We're going to move majority of the inventory, and we've timed production orders to go to that facility, the new facility rather than this facility. So the coordination piece is underway. It's just gonna be madness because we're moving this warehouse and then everything in it, same 10 days that Steph and I are moving into our new house. So the timing can be more perfect, but I'm just thinking about it. I saw, we did a walkthrough 2 days ago of the new spot. I cannot wait to show it to you guys because it's immaculate. Like, the things they did to it. Like I said, like, warehouse stuff, got a soft spot. Quick little Chipotle pickup for lunch. I want to go over the rest of my training plan for marathon prep the next like week and a half. So I have one more run this week, which is Saturday. I have 10 miles. Sunday is off. And then next week, which is the week going into the marathon, Monday 4 miles, Tuesday off, Wednesday 3 miles, Thursday off, Friday 3 miles, Saturday off, race day is Sunday. So I was talking with my coach, and after like the 16 miler or the 20 miler, which was like the deepest dig into prep for the marathon so far, my body was pretty taxed. Like, I was pretty fatigued and I was feeling it. Now as mileage decreases leading up into, I'm feeling a whole lot better. Like, energy's coming back, my body's feeling better. But I definitely, like, I reached that peak of training, which I was supposed to reach, which, so it was timed very well. But I felt it, and now I'm feeling better, so I'm excited for the marathon. And Preston signed up for the half marathon. We'll be there together.
Volunteer.
All right, so we got some good news. So the good news is they started paving the parking lots in the new warehouse. We were worried that it was gonna get delayed because of the weather. So if it was gonna rain or the weather was gonna be bad, it would have pushed back our move-in date even more. So the parking lot's getting filled right now and paved, which is a good sign. We might be moving in on time or sooner than expected. Wow! All right, check this out, guys. Tell me what you think. So we got a new logo for Embrace This Suck. I'm gonna use this for the training platform, and we're going to put this on a t-shirt for BPN. So let me know in the comments what you think of this logo and if you'd like to see it on a t-shirt. This logo right here was actually a campaign we did with the design crowd this month. So every month we do at least one campaign to launch like new projects or work on new logos or new graphic design for the website, stuff like that. So I've been working with them more often recently to work on t-shirt designs, and then some stuff coming up on that I'm gonna talk about here in a second, some designs, some graphic stuff for a new project Preston and I and the whole team here are working towards. And I've talked about a design crowd before, and they've been a great partner to have just because the resources available. Essentially, I went on design crowd like 7 days ago, and I launched a new project, and I just said, hey, this is what I'm looking for. Embrace a Suck, clean, modern, very punchy, that we can use for a t-shirt that's professional, and like we're marketing towards like the military demographic. And I gave them like fonts I was looking for and some similar designs I saw and found online, pitched it, and then within like 7 days, we had 100 plus designs submitted, and this is the one we chose. So if you're looking for something like design work, logo, graphics, anything, design crowd, I'll link it below. Absolute amazing platform. So I've been filming YouTube videos for almost, well, probably a little over 4 years now. When I first got to Texas in 2014, I picked up the camera and I started filming like my life. I started vlogging. And almost every 3 to 4 days since then, I've put up a video on YouTube. I've been documenting my life. And by no means am I saying like I'm tired of filming YouTube videos and putting vlogs up, but I'm kind of tired in the way that I'm doing it. I want to be more creative. I want to have a different like outlet and different approach to the way I'm filming videos and putting out videos. In this past year, I had this idea. I was like, man, I wish I could have like a TV show. If the team here could have like a reality TV show, that would be my like one of my goals that I want to accomplish. And I realized like it's right here. Like the reality TV show is, it's right here, it's this opportunity. And instead of like waiting on my moment for them to come to me, why don't I just create my own? And while I don't have like the team or the capabilities of putting on like a TV show on Netflix right now or a TV station, I have YouTube as an outlet. So why not create this YouTube series and seasons on YouTube with like a different approach to vlogging, like a behind the scenes of what we're doing right now, but just in a different kind of template. So I introduced to you Bear Brothers Season 1, which is gonna launch in the next couple weeks. So once we move into the new warehouse, and as we're moving into the new warehouse, Bear Brothers Season 1 is gonna launch. Each season is going to be 10 episodes, and we're gonna release one episode per week. I'm super excited to kind of plan and help produce this series because it's going to be different from, like I said, the vlog that we're currently doing and putting out there. It's going to tap into more of my creative side that I've been lacking, and I'm going to have assistance from other people to put it together. So Preston is going to stop packing orders, and we're going to have more people help with those positions. And Preston and I are going to be doing all the content creation for Bear Brothers Season 1. So you can expect just like the behind the scenes of the business stuff, fitness stuff. You can expect some craziness that we're going to experience here in Texas, some traveling, some jackass type stuff that Preston and I want to do and that we've been meaning to do. I was like, man, this is the perfect opportunity, the perfect platform. And I preach it all the time and I practice it, but this is just another opportunity where like this thing that you want, like this thing is right here on this platter. And everyone's always like waiting on my moment, waiting on my time to shine. If you keep waiting on that thing to come to you, chances are it's not gonna happen. If you go and you grab it and you create it yourself, whether it's as big and as great as you want it to be or it's a smaller scale, You're working towards your goal, your accomplishments, your dreams. And that's what we're doing. So Bear Brothers Season 1 is going to launch after the marathon. I hope you guys are ready. What are your thoughts of Bear Brothers Season 1 right now? Go.
Amazing.
John, what are your thoughts of Bear Brothers Season 1?
I am freaking jacked!
So tell the YouTube that this is how we're going to wrap up the video.
This is how we are going to wrap up the video.
Action.
He's just a poor boy in a poor family. Don't leave that out. He's just a poor boy in a poor family. Oh my god.
Dude, no. Yo,
come on. I'm not back again this time tomorrow. Carry on, carry on. If I'm not back again, carry on, carry on.